Welcome to John Deere Sprayer's Hydrostatic Powertrain Supplemental Video Training Segment. In this training video, we are going to review some information on how to best optimize the operational features of the hydrostatic powertrain used on the R4030, R4038, and R4045 sprayer and spreader chassis. Important note: always read and follow all safety and use information available in the machine's operator's manual, chemical labels, and MSDS sheets pertaining to all chemicals. Read and follow all PPE recommendations within these documents. All chemical residue must be disposed of according to local, state, and federal regulations. This video provides supplemental material and does not replace the operator's manual information and safety instructions outlined within it. These 4-series models offer cruise control and anti-stall features designed into the powertrain. They also offer control software that an operator needs to understand how to use properly. To obtain the best performance from the machine, let's take a look at these design features. This drivetrain system uses infinitely variable swash plates in both the hydro pumps and wheel motors. To reach a desired vehicle speed, the operator selects a target vehicle speed, miles per hour or kilometers per hour, by using the plus or minus button on the multifunction control handle. The target speed is then displayed on the corner post display. When the operator sets the engine speed to the maximum setting and pushes the hydro handle completely forward, the drivetrain enters a cruise control mode. This mode automatically uses the vehicle controllers and sensors to modulate the wheel motor swash plates to achieve the target vehicle speed. In order to optimally operate the drivetrain system in the field, the operator should always set the engine speed to the maximum setting. Then, move the hydro handle to the maximum forward position during operation. If a different maximum speed is desired, the operator should use the speed selection plus or minus switch on the hydro handle to change the target. This system also uses an anti-stall feature to automatically shift wheel motors when the machine is under load. This feature allows the drivetrain system to reduce load on the engine, which keeps engine speed from dropping too low due to excessive load. The anti-stall system is tuned to keep the combination of the engine and the drivetrain operating at maximum efficiency, resulting in maximum power to the ground during challenging operating conditions. In general, keeping the engine and hydro pumps operating at a high speed allows the pumps to generate more hydraulic flow, which in turn allows the wheel motors to operate at a position with higher efficiency than they would if the engine and pump speed was reduced. An operator who does not understand this feature's normal operation may think there is a power loss or mechanical slippage with the machine. For example, when climbing hills or soft ground, the anti-stall feature modulates wheel motors to slow down to keep engine RPMs high and hydrostatic pump flow high. The optimal operating point for the 4-series sprayers and spreaders when operating in higher load conditions, when climbing hills or soft ground, is when the engine is at its maximum power point of 2,000 to 2,100 RPM. This keeps the hydrostatic pumps at their highest RPM. When the pump RPM is held as high as possible, it keeps the motors at a higher, more efficient displacement, thus allowing more power to the ground. This is accomplished with the cruise control and anti-stall systems. To demonstrate how cruise control is activated, let's take a ride during field operation. The operator starts by setting the machine's top desired travel speed they will be running during spraying or spreading for that field's application. As a reminder, this maximum speed can be predetermined for the given application rate before going to the field by using a nozzle calculator for spraying or a feed gate spreadsheet calculator for dry nutrient spreader applications. In this example, we will say the predetermined maximum travel speed is 12 miles per hour and set that speed on the corner post. Next, we always want to run engine RPMs at maximum. Then start the machine safely and reach full multifunction control handle movement. Then, glancing at the corner post while moving, we see a cruise control symbol appear, telling us the machine's software is active and giving us peak operation of the powertrain. If we move either the control handle or the throttle control slightly off maximum, you see the cruise symbol disappear and the software control is not active, reducing the machine's capabilities. Since the multifunction control handle and its travel is critical to proper cruise control engagement, a calibration of the handle may be required occasionally. For example, calibration should be performed if any of the following components are replaced: the hydro propulsion handle, the forward, reverse, or park switch, the propulsion module, the armrest, the chassis controller, the hydrostatic control cable. There may also be need to perform the calibration due to normal wear of propulsion control components over time. The process only takes a few minutes and is fairly easy to perform. Recalibrate by moving the hydro handle to its full forward and full backward stroke length. This procedure stores the values of the potentiometer associated with the hydro handle position. When performing this operation, make sure to move the hydro handle slowly and go until stopping from resistance is achieved. Do not force the handle further in the intended direction. You may also need to hold the handle in the forward and rear positions when hitting the calibration store button because they might bounce back slightly. To calibrate, bring up the calibration page in the GS3 display and follow the on-screen instructions. Place the handle in the park neutral position. Press the cal button. Move the handle to the full forward position, then press the cal button. Move the handle to the full reverse position, then press the cal button. Calibration complete. Press the cal button to save. Note, if the calibration is aborted at any time during the process, the controller will revert to previous calibration numbers. If the calibration is completed and the calibration values are not in range, a message will be posted accordingly with a request to rerun the calibration. These John Deere 4 Series sprayer models have some great features, like cruise control and anti-stall, built into their design that enhances performance and customer satisfaction, making these machines the best in the market. We hope this video short was helpful. Please use the feedback loop for additional suggestions.